H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Over here, so you went to Java generator. One sec. Yeah, try any of these tools. Basically, you'll be having one. Let's say Java 2 UML. I think this one, you can probably use it. Try using it. If not, I'll see if I can pull in any other softwares for you. Okay, Java 2 UML. Okay, so there are a lot of tools, but the thing is, these tools, if you install it, after some times, they'll ask you to have the licensed version. Okay, so these are all not licensed, I believe. This you can just use it for a couple of days or so, and then you can install it again. Okay, all right, let's move on. So I was talking about string pool right here. New class, string pool. All right, so I was talking about a string name equals to Jairam, string name 2 equals to Jairam, string name 3 equals to Jairam. Okay, so when I run this application, can you guys tell me how many objects gets created here?
Three objects.
Right. Okay, I would prefer you guys just type in so that it'll be convenient to everyone. Okay. So I get a lot of questions, a lot of answers as 3, 3, 3, 1 from someone. Okay. Yeah, actually, okay. The person who has told 1, can you just give me why?
Because I read that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Java, if you, this is the literal, Java literal mm-hmm. string, Java will keep track of same literal. And then it keeps if you are creating another literal string, it will keep the same literal string and then give the pointer to it to the next variable.
Right, exactly. That's the point out here. All right. So what happens basically in your heap? You have got a string pool basically. All right. So what happens is when you say string name equal to Jairam, basically one object gets created out here. All right. And in that object, the value will be your Jairam. Okay, now what happens when you say name 2? Okay, so you have a reference which is referring to your this object. Now when you create name 2 out here, again what happens? A name 2 gets created. Instead of creating a new object, what happens? The same reference, he is going to refer to the same object out here. Okay, the same thing goes for your name 3. But what if I say name 4 equals to new of string? So when I say it in this way, basically it is going to create one more new object in the memory and it is going to assign that particular reference to name 4. Okay, so why is it like this? Now in Java, in real time, or if you guys are even practicing, you will end up using a lot of strings in your application. Okay, string is the mo- most common object which you use everywhere. Okay. Even though it is a character, let's say you say string flag. Okay. So it just in this flag you just got yes or no value. In this case you can use as a character also, but still I'm using a string out here. Okay. So everything you'll see every now and then you'll be seeing that you're using a string object out here. Okay. Now Java, for that reason, because if you end up creating multiple objects in your heap, okay, in your memory, so within no time your objects will be, I mean your memory will be full and it's gone. All right. So what happens is Java is pretty much intelligent enough that, and it is intelligent enough to say that whenever you create multiple string object with the same name, only one object will be created. That's what, and it will be kept in the string pool out here. All right. Anyone in the complete application, anyone in the entire application, when I talk about entire application, every application runs in its own virtual machine. Okay. And anyone in that application will use the string name as Jairam again. They will not create a new object. Instead, they will just refer that existing reference to the new reference. Okay. So for that reason, it is important to understand what is a string here. Okay. And let's say, I think in the previous example, we saw something name. Okay. Now, let us do one thing. Coming back to the two classes example, okay, pool, did we use that anywhere? Alright, so when I say, I want to say sys out and say name 4, I know I've already told you this as name, right? So this case I will obviously get a value as false. Now how do I make this as true? I'll just say name 4 dot equals. But when it's primitive data type, it's not like this, right? Right. It's not like that. It's not for primitive. This is only for your strings we are talking about in specific. So right click, run as Java application. So what happens? This is a kind of a method which is present in your object class, and it is, for that reason, present in each and every class. Okay, so you can just invoke dot equals on each and every class to make sure to check that whether these two strings are same or not. Now string has got an equals method wherein it does some functionality to check whether two strings are same or not. Okay, so how do I implement these, the same functionality out here? Now let's say I say human equals to new human, organize and say talk about this human, and I create a human with a country, let's say. So I create a human with country USA. Let me take one more with name, height and country. So name, height and country. Okay, now I want to create one more human 2 with same name, height and country. Now I say sys out human dot equals human 2. Now what will be the answer out here? Will it be true or false? Okay. All right. Okay. So Madhu, again, you gave the right answer and you read it somewhere. Okay. All right. So, Right. Yeah. So right click, run as Java application. I get it as false out here. Okay. The reason, when you just open the equals method, what it does basically, it checks whether these two belongs to the same reference or not. Okay. Now, if I say something like this, just make this as 1 1 equals to human 1. Now if I say human 1 dot equals to human 2, sorry, human 1 1, run this, right click, run as Java application, I get it as true. Okay, why do I get it as true? If you go and see the equals method, the default functionality of the equals method, it says this dot equals to equals to. When you talk about equals to, it always talks about the reference of that particular object. Okay, but when you talk about equals, it talks about the actual value. But when you talk about equals in string, it talks about the actual value. But when you talk about equals in any of the object, it is not. It basically checks whether these two are of the same reference or not. But still, I want to check whether these two humans are same or not. What I have to do is I have to override this particular equals method in my own class. So let me go to the human here and control space equals. All right. So what do I do here? I say, what is the shortcut to use to go super class then come back? Just say control, press the control and there is a super class. There is no functionality as such. Just press on your control key and then click on the class file in Eclipse. It goes to your actual file. Okay. Okay, so what do I do here? I just say, first of all, if you see here, what do I have it here as an argument, right? I have something as an object out here. Now, what am I passing out here? I'm passing a human out here, okay? Now, what do I do here? What should I do in order to convert my human reference to object, my object reference in this class to human? So my objective is, I just need to say if this dot country equals to the object which I passed on, that's what you are on this human dot equals to human 1 1. How do I do that? I have to go to your equals method. In this equals method, I have to check whether this particular class, that means, where is this? Okay, so this particular class country equals to this param object dot country. Okay, so if this dot country equals to this parameter object dot country and this dot, what is that here? Height. Okay, this dot height equals to param object dot height, and I want you guys to type in if you have the answer with you on what should I do in order to get rid of this compile time error, the one you see it. In the meantime, I'm just typing my code. So this dot name equals to param object dot name. Okay, so if this condition is true to me, I'm just going to say return true, else return false. Yes. So we are just supposed to say return false out here. Now what am I going to do here? I'll just remove this. This is not required for me. I'm going to do I just got only one answer out here from a lot of folks. I just got only one answer. That is not satisfactory to me, at least. You guys didn't go through the videos. Is there any way for querying a particular interface? Replace with equals, no. Querying a particular interface. I did not get your question, Madhu G. you say querying your interface, is there a way for querying a particular interface? What does that mean?
Like a kind of reflection, like you see if the object implements that interface or class or something.
See, when you talk about reflections also, we'll down the line we are going to do that. In that case also, you are going to see, okay, this is the particular object. So ultimately, you have to understand what is an object is, right? So on that particular reference itself, you are going to invoke those properties, okay? In reflection also, you'll do the same thing, okay? Anyways, when we talk about reflection, we'll talk about those things. I've got a couple of answers out here. So I just got only one answer, right? So let me just tell you what to do here. Now, what is this object out here? What is that? So the object is the one object we are passing as human. So what you have to do is, as we have referred it to, as this is the reference of your superclass, from superclass I have to cast it back to your subclass, right? So I just need to say here, human object. Okay, I'll just say here, human object equals to cast this, which one you're supposed to cast, param object, and use the same human object in all the places. So this equals to this, and this height equals to this, and this dot name equals to so and so. That means everything is fine. If all, okay. So if you want to see, if you see here, it was in single line and I was not able to see. So I just selected this particular line and I just told Control Shift F. Okay, so it got formatted for me and it is in two, three different lines. Okay. So ultimately you're saying if this dot country equals to the human object which you casted right now to country, and this dot height equals to height, this dot height equals to your human object this dot name equals to name. In that case, return true, otherwise return false. Okay. Let us go back and rerun the same application again. So right click, run as Java application. In this case, for me, both the conditions are true for me. Okay. So with the one equals, it does not produce Boolean value. See, there are different ways of implementing this. I could have, instead of this one, I wrote multiple lines of code, right? I can even say, return this. It's a single line of code, but just to make you guys comfortable, okay, I just added an if and else condition out here. Alright. Okay, so run as Java application, it is giving me true and true. Reason, when it comes here, it basically you're trying to check the values. Now it is your responsibility whenever you want to make sure whether two objects are same or not, you have to override your equals method. Okay, it's very important to understand what is an equals method, because down the line when we talk about collections, we will see what is the actual use of your equals method. So it is very important to understand what is an equals method out here. Okay. Any more questions? Uh-huh. Your voice is not clear. You're talking about overloading here. Let's do it here. Okay. So you have already equals method out here, right? So let me copy this and paste it out here. Okay. And I have, let's say, string name. So what did I do? I have overridden this particular method, right? But what is the use of overriding this particular method? Sorry, overloading this particular method. It's just a normal method, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, you're talking about this way, so you're just saying human out here. Yes, you can do that. You can do that. Okay. Yes, in practical, yes. Right click, run as Java application. Right, it does the same thing. So you can override it accordingly. So there is no harm in not overriding it in the other way out. Okay. But in more generic, you basically pass on an object, or yes, as you said, we can pass a human class also by there by itself, and we can achieve the same thing. Okay. All right. So, if you can provide real examples, it will be. Yeah, this is a real example. Indeed, you know, in real time, this is how you do it. Okay. And when we talk about collections, you see more examples out there to make you more comfortable. But in the real time also, you do the same thing out here. You know. Is it possible to use more real world application example to explain these topics? More real world examples. I'll try to do that, but I feel okay. Is there anything which you didn't understand in this particular topic?
Question that when we did the casting, first the question is that how did you make that the equals method from the object class appear on the screen? What did you press? Like,
you're talking about this one?
I'm talking about the with the equals method where we have overridden it.
Huh, okay. This one?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. You press something, then this the method appeared.
Right, here this is my string pool class, this is my client program. I just did a control and clicked on this. I've already told that in the session right now. Just say press control and click on the methods, and you go to that particular method in Eclipse.
All right. And the next thing is that when we learned about casting, we learned that we have a method, and suppose that method is the method is not available in a particular class, then we do the casting, right?
Correct.
So here we are doing the casting first, and I mean to say that why we are writing here, I understand that there is no method in this in this the one which you used before, but the object. But why we are doing it here?
Okay.
I remember we did like that. If we did the method was not available,
right?
We
right.
did the casting and then called on the method.
Okay.
I don't understand.
No, did you
yeah.
practice the other examples as such? Because if you would have at least done that, this would have been never come to your mind. But again, I'll just tell you that if you use a object out here, let's say I'm just renaming this to an object. Okay. Now tell me, from your client program, I'm passing a human here, right? Okay. Now in this case, if I use the same object, okay. So let's say this is not at all present anywhere for me. It's all blank. Now I have only the object here. I've got this. This is what when I talk about this one, the human one. I have got the human one details. I just say here, this dot name equals to. On which particular object are you going to compare? I just say object dot. Do you have name out here? There is no name out here. Yes. But I know that this object, the one which I'm passing, is of type human being. Okay.
Right.
Now, what should I do in this case? I should basically point to a particular class on which this particular this object has been passed. fast, right? Now I know that from my client program, I'm comparing two objects. On that, on this object, I'm passing one more object to check whether these two objects are same or not. Correct? Now, what is this human level 11? This human level 11 is nothing but an object, which is, we have already seen with the help of my superclass reference, I can create an instance of my subclasses, right? Let's say, for example, I can just say here, object human 12 equals to new of. So this is what you understand. Is it correct?
Yes,
right?
I understand all of this.
Now,
I don't understand why we are writing this casting inside the method. That's the whole thing.
Okay. So why are we writing this? Now tell me, if I do not write this, does this object has a name in it? It doesn't have it, right?
No, it doesn't have.
Now, what should I do in order to get that? I need to cast this object to a particular type. That is your human, HU, equals to, I have this object, no doubt. This object, I'll cast it to a particular class. Okay? Now, I at this point of time, I've got a human object. But, okay, on this human object, I'm going to say human.name. So this is, I get it as human.name. Okay, so this is a very generic method out here wherein we are just using an object. Okay, probably I'll give you one more example if you guys have time right now. Just give me 5 minutes. Okay, now let's take up one more example out here. Is there anyone who has the same kind of question? I can just give one more example to make you guys more clear on what we are trying to achieve here. Okay. Okay, so at least this example is pretty much clear why we are casting out here.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Let me take up one more example. Do I have anything here? Casting. Class casting client. Alright. I have got two classes. This is the very previous classes which we have discussed. One is a computer, one is a fish, right? So computer is again extending your object class, and your fish also must be extending your object class, correct? So if you see the hierarchy out here, you have got computer and fish. Computer extends your object class, and the same thing, fish extends your object class. Now what am I going to do is, where is my string pool? Now, here when I talk about equals, I have used a super class, right? Now, in this place, I could have even used, this is not extending anything. As this is not extending anything, I have used a super class out there. That is your object out here, okay? Remove this. Not interested in this now. Public, I know that. Okay, let me first run this, run as Java application. Okay, you got a class cast. Let me even comment this out. Let me first see what all methods present in a computer. So computer says sysout, I am a computer. And fish says swimming, okay? So computer says something and fish says something. Now what am I going to do is, I'm going to have a generic method, public void print me, and let's say, what is the superclass of both the classes? That is your object class. Copy this. Okay, before even copying that, let me take this. In this particular class, I want to print two functionality, one about computer, I want to print something about fish. Alright, now what I do, I know that two different classes, in this you have got a company method, in this the fish you have got swimming method, right? Now what do I do in order to invoke those functionality in a common functionality? I can very well do it in this way. I can say, let's say I'm using a computer out here. Let's say I'm going to use a computer out here, I'm going to use a fish out here. So on on this computer, I can just say, let's say I'm going to rename this as your computer, and this is as your fish. Now, when I say comp dot company and fish dot swimming, I am very good. Right click, run as Java application. I can very well do this functionality out here. Okay. I have no problems at all, but I want to separate these functionality. I don't want to invoke any of the methods in the same program itself. This is my design of doing a program, because there are a lot of designs you will be more comfortable not invoking invoking these APIs here. Instead of, you want to separate all these things in a particular, let's say here I just say invoke API, all right, application program interface. Now here in this case, I just want to invoke these things out in this particular method. So what do I do? I need to say computer, I have to pass this computer, okay, comp, comma, fish. Now here in this case, when I need to invoke this, I need to say static. Let me make this static as of now. So I just say invoke API and say comp and fish. So what did I do? I created a fish. And I pass the computer here and fish here as a reference. The same reference goes to your this one and this one. Okay. And on this, I just say comp dot company and fish dot swimming. Okay. Now I just took this out here and took this out here. Right click. Run as Java application. Well and good. No problems at all. Now tomorrow one more class has come up in picture. Okay. Now you are saying here I am creating one more computer out here. Okay. And just say Dell computer. Okay. So this is your Dell computer. Now what do you do? Do you go and change this signature as computer again? I can do that. Okay, I just say Dell here. And in this case, I'll just pass on Dell. And come here and just say DELL dot company. Right click, run as Java application. You get the desired result also here in this case. How many times will you go ahead and keep doing the changes out here? So be very generic out here. How will you make a generic API? Comment this out, copy this, paste it here. Now I know that for all these three, you have got only one superclass, that is your object class. Okay, this is my own predefined. I can just say it as object also. So as of now, I'm just say object OBJ, object class OBJ. All right, now let's see what is the trick I'm going to do right now. In this invoke API, I'm going to invoke this three times right now. Okay, in this, I'm just going to pass comp, I'm going to pass DELL, I'm going to pass fish. Now, what am I going to do in my API? I'm just going to say here, if this object is instance of, okay, if this is an instance of your computer, copy this, paste it out here, then cast this particular object OBJ to of type computer. Okay, and on this particular computer invoke my company. Okay, else if object instance of your fish the same thing. Take this object, okay, cast this to fish, and on this fish invoke the swimming. Now I have created a very generic, I will never come and change this API anymore. The only thing is, whoever calls this particular API with an object class, okay, any of the object, I'm good. You do any changes here, just pass on the object, it will come here and make the changes, I mean invoke the functionalities as it is. Right click, run as Java application. Does it make sense out here?
Yes, now it's clear what you were doing there.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, great. Yeah, guys, any other questions? If not, we have to wind up now. I've got one more class right now. So thanks for this session. And one more thing. Monday, I have got some official, it's an official party, yeah. So I cannot come on Monday. So we'll meet up on Tuesday itself, okay?
Was there a class yesterday?
No, there was no class yesterday. So
there is no class tomorrow, right?
There is no class tomorrow. And I believe you guys have got all the videos, proper videos now. Is it so? The videos are all.
I tried watching beginning classes. They are. I couldn't see anything.
I think they have uploaded all the videos right now, with proper clarity as well. And I would request you guys to go and check that again.
Okay.
I have received till videos 15. Is that with everybody? I wanted to check Jairam.
Yes.
Okay.
Right.
Jairam, what are you going to cover on Tuesday?
We'll talk about exceptions.
Okay.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.